you're going to get this green splash screen as it searches for devices. Currently, it is checking FOMI, which is my local area network. And there you go. It found all of my devices. I'm going to zoom in a little more because there's not much that actually happens on this particular screen. And that's both the plus and minus of this. It's the simplicity of the app itself. So here on the main screen, it will list all of your WeMo devices. In this case, I only have one smart plug. And from here, all you can do with this particular device is either turn it on or turn it off. Now, you will see it turns green when it is on, letting you know that it is on, and it is rather quick. Now, that is because I am on my current network. If I was off network and trying to do this, it would take a little more time for that to actually change. Coming up to the top here, you have this refresh button. So if you did have multiple devices, you could tap the refresh button, and if they weren't showing up before, hopefully by clicking the refresh button, they will then show up. If you want to make changes to a particular WeMo device, you have to click this little pencil icon to edit. Now from here, if you click and hold the three hamburger button, you could reorder any of the devices that you had. Now, if I wanted to change anything to do with this particular smart plug, I have to click the arrow, which then brings me into the editing settings for this particular device. So from here, I can edit the picture. This is the default picture for the WeMo smart plug that I have, but if I click on it, I can take a picture of the device or what it's turning on. I can choose a picture from my photo gallery to represent it. I can reset the photo, or in this case, I'm just going to cancel because I'm going to leave it as is. Likewise, if I wanted to change the name, click on the name, and there you can see I can change the name. Now, again, not going to do that, so I'm just going to cancel out. The other option from here is to reset options. So if I come here, I can clear product info, I can reset the Wi-Fi, or I can erase all content and settings. Now, that's kind of the nuclear option, so I'm not going to be doing that. If you made any changes here, you can hit save. In this case, I did not, so I'm just going to hit cancel. Last button at the top is this little sprocket or cog. Clicking on that will bring you into more stuff that's app related, not so much the WeMo plug itself, but I'm going to show it to you anyway, just so you have a good idea of what the app can do. Here you can enable or disable remote access. Now, if you do not have remote access turned on, you again will not be able to use this off network. So you'd only be able to use it when connected to your Wi-Fi network. So you want to turn that on. Settings and about, again, we're going to come over here and it's just going to show you some of the settings. In this case, I have it remembering my Wi-Fi settings. It's location, app info, hardware info, legal. I'm not going to bring you through all of them because it's really just basic information, but I want you to see where these things are. So if you have if this then that, you can connect your WeMo account to if this then that and have all sorts of fun with that. I do not have IFTT yet. I've been really considering it, so this might be my push to actually do that. Connect to Nest. I do not have a Nest device. I would like a smart thermostat, but don't have one right now. Here, if you wanted to add more WeMo devices, because you did see the setup process, but that was when I first started using the app and had only one device. So now that I have the app and an account and I want to add more devices, I would come here and it would bring me through the process. What do I have? Do I have another smart plug? Do I have a dimmer, etc., etc.? I'm just going to cancel out of that because I do not have another device to set up at this moment. And scrolling down, you have support and feedback. So you have tutorials, WeMo community, support articles, get in touch, and rate WeMo. Coming back to the main screen, now you'll notice that it's searching for the devices again. It's gonna do that every time you come to this screen. Now, if you're on the screen and close the app, and here, actually, I'll show you. If I close the app and then come back to the app, it doesn't have to do that search because it's still within the memory. WeMo does not push firmware updates from the application itself. So if the app isn't on and there's a firmware update for the plug, it does not push notify you that, hey, there's an update. You have to come into the application itself to see that there is an update. So if you're just using this with Amazon Echo and you never come here, you're never really going to know that there is a firmware update. So I would recommend on occasion, you know, maybe once a month, just coming into the app and seeing if there's any firmware updates, because that is one thing that WeMo has been really good about, is pushing firmware updates. So Coming down to the bottom, you will notice that we are currently on devices, and that would list out all of your devices. I only have the one right now. If we select rules, this will allow us to set up rules. Now, right there, it's looking to see if I had any rules set up. Now, by default, you have several selections of rules. You have a schedule. So if I click on schedule, since I only have the one plug, it's just showing me. So I can turn on or off living room and when. So if I select, and again, clicking any of these will bring you into more options. Just keep in mind, I only have the one device. So living room, I can turn on or off, on until time, on or off. When do I want this to start? Selecting this will allow me to have it on or off, and then I could start at and tell it a particular time, as well as days of the week that I want. Now, I'm not going to hit done because that will lock in the rule, because I'm not actually trying to make a rule, but we can also create a rule name. So I'm going to go back. We can also do auto off timer. So automatically turn off my particular device, again, because I don't have any other devices, but you select it after the device has been on for 1 hour, or, you know, starts at 1 minute and goes up to an hour, or you can select a custom time. So plus or minus however long you'd like it. So let's say you have kids and they, you know, around 8 o'clock, they go into the den, they watch TV for an hour or so, and they leave, and they always leave that light on. Well, doing this will let you turn that light off after a specific set, specific amount of time. Or maybe you're kind of giving them a cue, hey, it's time to get out of the room and go to bed. This is where you would do that. You can say when, all day, or again, just like before, you can select start day, on or off, time, time to start, time to turn off, and then days of the week that that particular rule will be in place. And again, you can name this particular rule so you know what it is if you have to go back and edit. Now I'm going to go back because I'm not saving any rules at this time. There are extra things in here that I do not have access to because I don't have devices that correspond with them, such as long press, which requires to have a WeMo dimmer, motion detecting, which needs a Nest cam or a WeMo sensor, or Nest Away, which is for the Nest thermostat. Don't have that. You also have automate, which is right now, if I click on it, we have a rule called away mode. So this is kind of like you're setting up lights turn on this time, lights turn off on this time to mimic you being home. So since I only have the one switch, it's automatically connected, and I can, when, by selecting that, choose again, start on, what happens? Does it turn on? Does it turn off? Start off, or sorry, turn off. So start at this time, turn off at this time, and then select days of the week. So again, it will mirror what you, your activities while you're home. And get notified, again, these require specific things. So motion alerts and usage alerts requires a WeMo Insight, don't have that. And this one requires a WeMo sensor or a Nest cam, both of which I do not have. And then again, this cog up in the corner here does exactly what it did on the devices page. So that is a quick, well, not really quick, but that is a look through the WeMo app itself, as well as what you can do with the Switch.